This is Tom with Jerry's Tap Removal. We specialize in the repair of broken bolts, broken taps, and often the repair of damaged threads. What we have here is a Toyota that overheated, that pulled the threads. The vehicle came in here to have us Timesert it, which is about the best fix. It is the best fix that you can use. It's a very common problem. We have a Toyota here and we have a Toyota behind us, and they both came in for the same problem, pulled threads. Toyota Camrys, Highlanders, RAV4s, we have a Scion and behind this car. This particular motor has a problem of overheating, and when it overheats, it generally expands the head, swells the head, weakens the thread, ultimately pulling the thread, rendering it weak so that it does not hold torque. So commonly what a mechanic will do is change a head gasket, try and put it, have the head resurface, put it back together, and at that point usually discovers that that particular hole or all the holes are not going to hold the factory torque spec. At that point, they send it over here to have that hole repaired. The method that we use for repairing that thread is installing a solid thread insert made by a company called Timesert or Time Fastener Company. This is their kit here you see in the video. This is a picture of the insert that we're going to install. It's 30 millimeters long. The inside diameter is original stock 11 by 1.5. The outside diameter is a typical STI or standard thread insert size. So it's about a half size over. What we're going to do is we're going to install a fixture on top of this motor. We're going to drill it. There's three steps to it. We're going to drill it. We're going to counterbore it so that the head of the insert fits down inside. These holes, the thread starts at 3 inches from the surface. So we're going to use their kit and their fixture to bolt to the top of this head for alignment. And then we're going to, at that point, do all our machine work to get the hole prepared for installing the Timesert. This kit that we're showing you right now is made by Time Fastener Company. It's called a Timesert kit. It's a 11 by 1.5 universal head bolt repair kit. Well, what we have in the kit is, first of all, our guide going to be installed in this location right here. We have the core drill, what they call a step drill or a core drill. It has two diameters. The smaller diameter is for the size of the thread that we're going to put in it. The larger diameter is for the counterbore, which oversizes the hole to allow the head of the insert, which you can see has a head on it, or a shoulder. Now that's what stops the insert from going too deep. This step right here in their core drill will determine how deep this goes. This particular drill comes with a collar or a stop that's adjustable. This comes in contact with the bushing that you install in the fixture. It will stop. It'll control the height of the hole that you're drilling, which is important. Because this second diameter on this core drill is what determines the height of the insert or where the insert stops. And where we want the insert to stop is exactly 3 inches from the surface of the head. Now at this point, I have the guide plate or fixture on location using the locating pin and two bolts that are going into good threads, holding this plate in position, preparing it for machining. So at this point, we install a bushing that is used that actually fits this core drill right here that does the drilling and the counterboring for this job. This bushing is going to slip in this hole. Once that bushing is in that hole, and this drill is going to drop down inside, and we're going to drill our hole. Timesert provides a scale that you use to measure from the shoulder on this core drill up to where you want the drill to stop. So you take that measurement, which we have, and that's correct. That's exactly where I want it to stop. You lock this collar in place with a set screw. Now, Timesert has made this tooling so that you can use a standard or conventional electric drill. In this case, we're using a Milwaukee. Now, what we like to use here for a lubricant, lubricating the drill, is WD-40. We squirt a little bit in the hole, and it helps the cutting. So at this point now, we're going to go ahead and we're going to put the core drill in. We've completed our core drill. We've got to completely blow the hole out, get rid of all the chips. If chips say pack up in the bottom of the hole, then the tap that you use for the threading will not go deep enough. It'll pack up against the chips in the bottom of the hole. So at this point, you reinstall the bushing, which guided the core drill, which also guides the tap. We'll put the tap in here. I think rather than under power, I'm going to go ahead and hand tap this because I have a little more feel for that. Our ratchet. You get a better feel for when you're at the bottom of the hole. It's tapping beautifully. It's cutting the amount of material. That's what I love about Timesert kits, is that their core drill diameters are right on size. Their counterboring diameter is right on size, which is all part of the core drill. The smaller diameter being the diameter for the tap, and the larger diameter being oversized to allow the head of the insert to go down inside and stop at the diameter that we predetermined by adjusting the collar on Timesert's core drill. So at this point, now we've completed our tapping. Also at this point, I can remove the fixture or the guide plate that Timesert provided. We can put this away now. Okay, at this point you have what they call their third tool, which is an installation tool. So what takes place when you install this insert is it not only finishes threading the insert in, but installs the insert, it finishes threading and expands the bottom, and that's in conjunction with Loctite holds the insert in. So at this point, we can partially install the insert. It has to be free of any grease or oil. So a lot of people will use brake clean. My preference is acetone. You can't have any grease or oil, or the Loctite that we're going to use to hold that insert in will not hold. Okay, the next step is to install the insert that we just prepared the hole for. I'll put the Timesert partway on the installation tool, drop a little bit of lubrication in here. That helps the tapping, the finish tapping, or the installation of the insert. It lubricates the tool and the insert. The next thing you do is put a small drop of high temperature Loctite that Timesert provides in their head bolt repair kit. Okay, so we're ready to install the insert. Okay, you feel a little bit of pressure from the installation tool, Timesert's installation tool, going past the tap, finishing threading, and expanding the bottom. And that concludes that repair. The insert's in. All I have to do is back the tap back out, and Timesert is installed and installed at the right height, the original height of where the threads begin on this motor from the factory, 3 inches from the deck. Okay, this is another Toyota block that we fixed out of hundreds over the last 6 months that will have no future problem. I would say beyond, they're better than stock. They have a nice steel insert in them now. The head bolts are held in by steel inserts, not by the original aluminum. They're Loctited in, they will not come out, and they will hold the proper torque, if not a little more. I would say I probably do in the range of a half a dozen a month of Toyotas, of different models. This same motor is used in the Scion and the Highlander and the RAV4, so it's a very common motor. And this problem is very common. And it always starts with overheating. When the motor overheats and the head expands, it softens the aluminum, it stretches the threads, and the best fix for that is to install a Timesert.